Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. It's been a while since we took apart a power bank last time. Today we got a powerful power bank from CUKTECH called No.30. It's equipped with a 40,000 mAh battery pack and the total amp power can be up to 300 watts. But you can still take it anywhere like camping and traveling. Let's open it first. Except for the power bank itself, this box also contains the user manual and a cable. The TreasureLab Power ZKM003C shows this USB-C cable has an 8-market chip and can support up to 240 watts. It has a display on the front which shows the current status of this power bank. The power button is a strip, laser engraved CUKTECH. Two USB-C and two USB-A ports are at the bottom. There is a plastic handle on the top for easy carrying. The wireless charging area is below the plastic handle. Put your phone on it and start charging instantly. Two rubber strips on both sides are made for overheating issue of wireless charging. Except for that, it also integrates a cooling fan on the back to improve heat dissipation performance. All specs info are below the cooling fan. Model is P01CT. The rated capacity is 141 Wh. As for the upper power of each port, you can pause to view the details. There is also a large silicon pad at the bottom of the power bank to ensure stability on the table. The size of the power bank is about 106x82x87mm and the weight is about 1.13 kg. The TreasureLab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C one supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, 5.0, PD3.0, PPS, DCP, and FO 2.4M protocols. And the USB-C one also supports 5 fixed videos of 5 volts, 9 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts, 3A, 20 volts, 5A, and 2 sets of PPS. The biggest difference of USB-C 2 is that it supports the USB PD 3.1 protocol. It has 6 fixed videos of 5 volts, 9 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts, 3A, 20 volts, 28 volts, 5A, and 2 sets of PPS. As for USB-A1, it supports FCP, AFC, QC 2.0, DCP protocols. And the USB-A2 supports FCP, AFC, QC 3.0, PD 3.0, and DCP protocols. The USB-A2 also supports 5 fixed videos of 5 volts, 9 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts, 3A, 20 volts, 5A. Next, let's try to take apart this power bank from the front panel. The display is fixed with double-sided tape and screws. Remove those screws and disconnect the front panel from the battery. The solder joints are covered with silicone adhesives. Most of the internal space is occupied by the battery pack. The top wireless charging area is also fixed with double-sided tape and screws. Tear off the silicone pad at the bottom. Here is the connector of wireless charging module. Then take out the entire battery pack. We can see the cooling fan inside. Continue to remove the remaining screws. And separate the cooling fan. First, let's introduce the PCBA module for wireless charging. The charging circuit is under the metal shield. The wireless power transmitter is from NuVolta, which integrates multiple protection functions. The MOSFET is from Toshiba, 30 volts, 6.8 mA. The resistor capacitor is coated with yellow resin. Next, let's remove all screws that fix the battery pack. And then clean up the potting compound. There are 8 Samsung 21700 batteries inside, which are fixed by the plastic frame. Two sets of 4 batteries connected in series are connected in parallel. Then let's check the other side. There is a thermal pad inside the cover, and the PCBA module is fixed inside the frame by screws. Then separate those two parts. It consists of 2 layers connected by 2 sets of pins for higher space utilization. And nickel strips of battery pack are connected to the lower PCB. This is the power button, with a TVS for electrostatic protection. The voltage of the battery pack is about 16.6 volts. The lower PCB is also fixed in a black frame. After removing it, we can see those nickel strips. We even found the outer case adopts aluminum alloy after scraping off the black paint. Then let's go ahead and introduce all components one by one. The battery protection chip is from Cellwise, which supports 3 to 4 lithium batteries connected in series and multiple battery protection functions. Those two MOSFETs for battery protection are from AOS and adopt DFN 5x6 package, 30 volts, 2.75 milliohm. The buck boost controller is from Southchip SC8815, used to convert DC input voltage. It can control the charging of the battery pack and USB-C output. The synchronous buck boost MOSFET is from AOS and adopts DFN 5x6 package, 40 volts, 5 milliohm. Those two solid capacitors for output filtering are connected in parallel and used for the 140 watts output, 35 volts, 100 microfarad for each. For the 100 watts output circuit, two MOSFETs for battery protection are the same model as the 140 watt circuit, and this solid capacitor is from CapXon, 100 microfarad, 25 volts. The buck boost controller for 100 watts output is also from Southchip SC8815. This MCU is from AMEC and adopts QFN32 package, used to drive the display. It can show the real-time battery capacity and input and output power. Those two current sense amplifiers are from 3-peak, used to detect the current of two buck boost circuits. Next, let's move on to another PCB, which has two synchronous buck boost circuits for the outputs of two USB-A boards. The synchronous buck boost controller for the 120 watts USB-A output is also from Southchip SC8815. It has three chips of SC8815 in total. Those four MOSFETs on the front and back are from Infineon, 30 volts, 4.5 milliohm. The 2.2 microhenry alloy inductor is used for the buck boost conversion of 120 watts USB-A output. Those two solid capacitors are from CapXon PM series, 100 microfarad, 25 volts for each. The synchronous buck boost converter for the other 22.5 watts USB-A is different from the other three boards, from Southchip SC8721. This buck boost inductor is used for the 22.5 watts USB-A. Two protocol chips of two USB-C ports are from Jardot and adopt TQFN-24 and TQFN-16 packages. We also find a similar chip in the teardown video of Anker 140W PD3.1 power bank. The MCU is from ABOV, used to control different functions of this power bank. The USB hub controller is from Genesis, used for the expansion of USB ports. Those two VBUS MOSFETs for USB-C output are from AOS. The other two VBUS MOSFETs for 120W USB-A output are from Toshiba. Well, as the world's smallest 300W power bank, you can regard it as a mini version of the portable power station. If you don't need AC power when you're out, you can consider it. After taking it apart, we found it consists of 8 battery cells, 2 stacked output PCBs, wireless charging module, and a cooling fan. The internal structure is pretty compact and solid. With the top handle, you can take it anywhere you want, except on the plane. Okay, that's all for today's video. Feel free to click the link in the description if you want to support them on Indiegogo. See you in the next video. Bye!